Hey guys, and welcome back to Thornton Farm. Now then, in this series we are going to be sort of taking the role of a council and a lawn care company. So we've got three Unimogs. We have them in different configurations. We've got the tipper on the back, we've just got the flatbed with no linkages. Then we've got this one with the linkages. They will be a modded Unimog 1600. And we've also got the Land Rover Defender 90. Two of these trailers, which are quite useful, a log carrier, Tatra front loader. Now if we go in here to our workshop, we have New Holland T7210, I believe, with the front mower and rear mower, a little John Deere ride-on mower there, lawn tractor thing, a couple of lawn mowers there, with one of them's got the baggage collects that X mark there has. JCB skid steer with the stump grinder and log forks, and also this little stand-on mower. So we basically do all of the work on here. For example, Stone Henge and the castles and that, we cut the grass around there. So I think what better to start than cut Stone Henge, if I can find it. Not entirely sure where Stonehenge is on here, but we could take this New Holland tractor. Let's open up the back doors here, a bit easier. And we'll drive down in this. And we'll go cut the grass. So we own this little plot of land here. I have in fact edited this, so this was originally just one big grass field, so I made it a bit of concrete and put the shed there, and accidentally put this massive patch of dirt here, but oh well. So I believe Stonehenge is possibly down here, depending on which one we get to first. That castle looks quite nice. We do in fact cut the majority of the grass on here, so verges and that, we do the council's job. We also do a couple of the council houses, we do the front lawns on there, the church, pub, basically anywhere that there's grass, we do, apart from the fields that the farmers own. Stonehenge, that's a National Trust place, I believe, so we don't need any permission to do that, we just do that because we're employed to. We need to find Stonehenge first though, I'm not entirely sure where it is on this map. It does go on for quite a while down here. Rain store, Thornton Farm, vehicle shop. Don't think it's up at that top end of the map either. I think it's around this area. It's clearly not down there, is it? So this tractor is in fact a mod, it's from the New Holland mod pack. I sort of chose this because I quite like the change. I could have chosen class or case or another brand, but I thought, you know what, we haven't used New Holland for a while, let's go with it. It'd be worth it, I think. It's either council sort of use New Holland or case or some other brands. What's this up here then? I believe this is a field that we can actually cut. But it's a castle. So yeah, we could actually do this at some point. Yep, the castle, we get employed to do this every now and then. See if I can see Stonehenge. Just park that there actually, that's going to roll down the hill. Let's whack on the handbrake, there we go. So yeah, the castle is quite a nice place, and the walk on mowers and that we will do down here, so we can't get the tractor down. Around this area we use the little mowers for. So yeah. Right, can't quite see Stonehenge, so I'm not entirely sure where it is. Let's just drive down here. yeah, this is it's quite a nice map, is Thornton Farm. Well, yeah, we won't be doing any farming on it, but it is just quite nice for this sort of work. Now this will be in place of one of the series, so it'll be quite good. Right, where should we go? Can't see Stone Henge on the map there anywhere. Right, I know where it is. Hopefully. I want to turn left up out of here. Turn left up out of here. Then go all the way up this road. This road's a bit of a pain as well. I must have spent about an hour getting all that equipment moved down. Because there's certain places on this map where you can't easily turn left with a massive trailer. So I just have to do it normally. Once we've done the main part of Stonehenge though, I'll bring one of the Land Rovers down, or the Land Rover with the trailer on, or Unimog or something. And we'll just bring down one of the little mowers, and then we'll just finish up around the main attraction. Make that look quite nice. So we also currently have £45,000, and that will end up decreasing soon, and increasing. And we're possibly going to buy another mower. But we do actually own a fair amount of equipment, which is quite good. I believe Stonehenge is up here past the shop when we turn left. So there's a big class dealership here. I should have gone for class really, but I'm using that on a different map. I'm using that on Knaveswell Farm. Right, turn left here, I believe. Oh, hello, we don't want that down just yet. So yes, Stonehenge. And a plane. So, we get paid for this, paid £1,000 for this job of here. I think, I don't know what's the easiest way to do this. I think we'll just go around, need these people to move out the way first. So I need to make this look quite nice. I think what we'll do this cut, and then one of the farmers can come and get the grass up, but we cut it. So the farmer will pay us for the grass. So we get paid £1,000 for cutting it. And that is without grass removal. And then we get paid about £500 for the grass, for like this half, and then over there £500. We could get £2,000 from this job if the farmer really wants to take us up on the offer of having the grass. And one thing that we also do on here, we do the big industrial part down there at the bottom right, so blue sphere stores and biotech, and that we mow the hill on there. It's quite a big hill that surrounds it, so I probably won't use this tractor. It's a bit too big, I think, for doing that. It'll be either one of the self-containing mowers which picks up the grass, or the John Deere. They're not fussed there about having the grass picked up, so yeah, we won't do that. Alright, this is going to be a bit of a pain, this, every now and then. Alright, let's just go down for that and do that extra little bit there. So this job shouldn't take us too long. I mean, we're 10 minutes into the video now. But yeah, it doesn't usually take that long to cut all around here. I mean, up on there, the grass isn't actually too long. Because originally there was a council doing that part, and this big field, it was us. But we've basically taken on the council's job as of budgeting reasons. They felt it was unnecessary to have a mowing division since our company was still operating. So we have recently purchased this tractor. This is brand new. The Unimogs and that, they're fairly old. John Deere tractor, that's not that old. Yes, £45,000 we have. That can go a long way. I don't know what I may buy, but I'm looking at a van. What would be quite nice is to have a van that I can put some of the equipment in instead of driving down a Unimog and trailer. As I think that would be quite good. If we just put the little stand on mower in the back of the van, and we drive down to a job like this, for example. But yeah, these jobs are quite nice actually. This is going to be our grass for my channel, I think. I've seen videos on YouTube of people doing series like this, but not on such a big scale, where they take on the role of like the local council and that. But it's a bit like the snow plowing series. Never really done it before, but people seem to enjoy it. So we'll carry on doing it because people enjoy it. I think we'll do it this way actually, because then technically I spend less time turning. For example, it won't leave as much there. For example, that'd be the maximum there. We'll do it in rows. There is enough space on here to turn properly now. Yeah, local farmer will come collect this, do whatever he wants, sell it, or clamp it. Quite often they clamp it. Yeah, I might at some point as well get a JCB telehandler, because for some of the smaller jobs we are going to keep. We're just going to make a little grass pile at the side of the shed or something, or out on the front, concrete. And basically we'll just keep the grass on there, and then you can load it up into a trailer. So I might buy JCB telehandler for that job. It would also be quite good as well, because on here we do take the role of doing the trees as well. For the council we do, and then a couple of the little gardens, we keep their gardens up, and the little houses. Definitely at the roundabout as well, there's a couple of trees which we will end up felling at some point. Right, I'll go up to the top and then we'll turn around, just get this last little bit here. That could have made our job 10 times harder. So quite a good little system we've got here actually. I'll do this on the other side. And I think we'll do what I did up there on that side as well, because I can imagine that I'm going to end up missing some. For example, there. And there. Yeah, I'll go around it once more. I might end up changing the cut grass texture as well, because I don't really like it. It's a bit too yellow as well for a place like this. If you want it like green grass, you don't want yellow patches of grass, do you? I don't know if you pay for visiting places like this or you just get them for free. So it's also one of those landmarks. For example, the council, they probably get paid for renting out the car park or something. As well, verge cutting, I don't think we're going to do that, simply because the mower which I was going to end up using just doesn't decide to work properly. For example, the other day I was attempting to record this and I was using that mower, and outside one of the industrial properties there is a few signs for the dairy and that, and it clips into one of the signs and then it sent the whole thing flying. So yeah, I'm not a huge fan of that mower. That's why you won't be seeing it in any of this gameplay. Although it probably would come in handy if it worked properly. So we've almost done this half. And then the farmer will come and collect this up. And it'll be gone for next episode, I think. Or, that you never know, they might collect it up and then just say, yeah, you keep it at your headquarters. And I think actually that's what will probably happen. We don't really want to go down the line of recording the grass picking up and that. Right, where next? Right. So yeah, the little mower's going to come in handy for these little places and on the hill and that. Some poor. This is sort of split up into three sections. So you've got this up here, this across there, and then you'll have down there. I think that's how I will end up doing it. So I am going to try and do a lot more in cab. It makes the videos better if I do it in cab, I think, a bit more realistic. Which is sort of what we want. And I do this in cruise control as well, it makes it a bit easier. Well, for the trees and that, I was just thinking I'm not going to have a wood chipper. I was just going to sell the logs. But do you think I should buy a wood chipper? But the wood chipper wouldn't go to the job sites. It'd be trees get cut down, trees get moved back to the headquarters, that shed that we own, and I'd chip them there because I'd have like a permanent chipping area. And they're sort of cordoning off and that. I think that would be quite good. Yeah, or it could just be park the Land Rover in the middle of the road, set up the wood chipper and that on this tractor. Because the Unimogs, unfortunately, haven't got enough power to power the wood chipper. Otherwise I would have done that. But I can tow a trailer on the Unimogs, so that's okay. Do that. Yeah, I am going to use a big range of different mowers and equipment. For example, that X-Mark pack, and it's got a walker mower in, and strimmer as well. If there was a working one that didn't fall over every time you turned a corner quite sharply, I would use it. So I think that'd be quite good up there. Just sort of go and do it. We'll leave a verge around the edge of here, I think, make it look quite nice. imagine people probably come onto this main area here, have a picnic or something, because the grass will be much shorter. I am going to set the grass, the grow rate, to slow, because I can imagine if once we cut this once and done possibly the roundabout or something, we'll have to come back and cut this. So I will leave it every now and then to grow. Yeah, as well, the roundabout we need to cut. That's if, yeah, it's about the strimmer. If I had that, that'd be mainly used for basically everything. That is quite good. Yeah, this main section here, it's the biggest. We're getting this done quite nicely, actually, quite quickly. I think it helps as well because I'm not too fussed about getting into neat lines or anything, because it's not as if, yeah, it's not as if it's this company doing it. So I've just been told to cut it. And round the edges here, I will go round with the main little mower. So I'll leave possibly enough space for two passes. I can't imagine people walking along there with like this big tractor and this massive spinning thing going very close to their legs. Hill, that'll be cut with the walk on stand on mower. Yeah, I've got a plan for this, which is a lot more than I've got for any other series that I just do. Yeah, once we've done this, I'll drive up onto there with this folded up and I'll get a screenshot for the front of this video. It's probably easier if we split this up again to, yeah, so this has actually got about four main sections, that and that, so it makes it easier though, actually, because for example if you only end up cutting that half, you don't leave half of this, like just left, for example, I wouldn't drive off now and just leave that grass like it is. Right. So, well, would you guys like to see more of this? This is sort of a new sort of series for me. Like I said earlier, snow plowing's the closest thing I've done to this sort of council work thing. But yeah, I think it'd be quite good, hopefully. Hopefully you guys enjoy it. I sort of like this sort of mowing. It's actually, you've sort of got an objective, because if you don't do it well, they won't pay you as well. Right, off screen I might drive up the, well, a vehicle with the little mower, so we can do that next episode, if you guys want to see an episode 2 of this. Then we've got, this is one of the biggest properties that we have to cut. So, I don't know, for the houses and that, I'll be able to get about 3 of them done an episode, so that'd be like, yeah, that'd be an episode just doing a few houses. The roundabout and verges, verges, they're going to take the longest because there's so many of them that we've actually got to do. But I'm not entirely sure how I'm going to do that yet because of this mower that's messing up. Right. Do this last little bit, and then I can do that tiny bit there. Then we are done for today. Surprised how fast I've actually managed to do this. Oops. Click V by accident when I'm going in cap. Then I clicked X. Oh well. Go over it with this front mower. It's only a little bit. Right, so I haven't got any comments as well because I'm recording this like a week early, so yeah, I'm trying to get videos done, recorded earlier than I normally do, so I've got time to not do the videos and spend a couple of days just recording. For example, the GoPro stuff, that I did that in an afternoon. And they uploaded, it took about 10 minutes to upload each. So it was an hour of uploading and I was done. That's a week's videos there. It's taken an afternoon. So yeah. So well, I'm going to do some reviews of gear. I don't know what gear I'm going to review. For example, that's a keyboard. Might review that, I don't know, but I'm not entirely sure if this mouse and keyboard is available anymore. The steering wheel I would review, but I'd give it a really bad review because it broke. The pedals broke on it. What else can I review? I don't know. I would like to contact some companies and just say, have you got anything that I could review for the channel? For example, I don't know how many subscribers we are now, about 750, something like that. For example, if every single one of you purchased that product, it's like 750 units that they've sold because of just at the cost of shipping one unit out for free to someone. For example, smaller YouTube channels, I don't understand why people don't. Corsair, I've contacted them, and if you get over 1,000 views per video, then they can send out units. So you could see, I don't know, soon if the channel grew that much, you could see some Corsair reviews or something. I think it's Corsair anyway. Should be. Almost certain it is, actually. Other companies, for example, I was going to have a review unit of a shoulder rig for a camera, but the company haven't replied to an email in 3 months, so I've just thought there's not really any point chasing that up anymore. Probably over 3 months now, actually. Right. That's that done. We'll let the farmer come and rake this up and do whatever they want to do with it. For now, I'm going to go and drive this up here. And we'll get a screenshot. Please don't walk on where I'm driving. Some people as well, just like, oh yeah, let's walk in front of a tractor, walk through the tractor. So thanks for watching, guys. I really hope you have enjoyed this episode on Thornton Farm. There will be a lot more of this coming, hopefully. If you guys enjoy it, please let me know in the comments if you want us to see more. And yeah, so Thanks for watching. See you next time. Goodbye.